Republican Senator Markwayne Mullin challenged Teamsters General President Sean O'Brien to a cage fight, because that is what politics has devolved into in the United States. Now, the two have been beefing for quite some time now, so let's get into this pretty hilarious and insane feud. So Mullin and O'Brien, just to back up and give you the context before we fill you in on what happened today, had first sparred back in March of this year. So O'Brien had attended a Senate hearing on union busting, and here's what happened.
What job have you created? One job, other than sucking the paycheck out of somebody else that you want to say that you're trying to provide because you're forcing them to pay dues?
No, we don't force them.
Senator, you've asked the question.
You're out of line.
Let him
answer the question. And don't tell me I'm out of
line. You are out of line.
Don't tell me I'm out of line.
Well, you frame the statement.
You need to shut your mouth.
Yeah.
Because you don't know what you're talking about.
You're going to tell me to shut my mouth?
Yes, I did.
Hold it. Hold it.
Tough guy. I'm not afraid of physical.
Senator, hold it.
But don't sit there and tell me I'm out of line.
I bet you I work more hours than you do. Twice as many hours.
That's impossible.
No, that's true.
Sir, you don't know what hard work is. You want to follow schedule.
Secondly, I'll do it in a minute.
That's
we hold greedy CEOs like yourself accountable.
You call me a greedy CEO.
Oh yeah, you are. You want to attack my salary, I'll attack yours.
So was Markwayne Mullin a greedy CEO? That's what he was accused of in that exchange. And let's give you the details on that, and then we'll proceed to what transpired today. So asked by O'Brien how much he made from his plumbing business, Mullin claimed, quote, "I kept my salary down at about $50,000 a year because I invested every penny into it," meaning his business. But in 2013, then Representative Mullin reportedly pocketed more than $600,000 from the companies in violation of House ethics rules and federal laws limiting how much outside income members of Congress are allowed to receive. So that $50,000 number was, a little misleading to say the least, but there's more. Although Mullin transferred ownership of the companies to his family, he continued to serve as a board member and chief advertiser while raking in hundreds of thousands of dollars. As O'Brien pointed out on social media, Mullin saw his reported net worth surge from between 7.3 million and 29.9 million at the end of 2020 to between 31.6 million and 75.6 million after he sold his family's plumbing companies in late 2021. Just some context, so you understand the feud, the ongoing feud between Mullin and O'Brien. Now, last week Mullin referred back to his confrontation with O'Brien at a different hearing. Let's watch that.
The bill, however, is not about increasing the quality of an employer's employee relationship or allowing the free market to lift millions of workers out of poverty. It's about increasing the power of union bosses, like the one that was here one time over the union or over the union bosses for the Teamsters, O'Malley, who quoted one time saying that he wants to bring the mob mentality back to the Teamsters. That's who you're empowering, Chairman.
O'Malley's not the right name, it's O'Brien. So he must have misspoke there.
But racist against the Irish.
Now he got called out for that though, Cenk. He got called out by O'Brien.
I like O'Brien's attitude.
I do too, he's a fighter. So here's what he wrote. "Hey John Wayne Mullin, first off, my name's O'Brien, not O'Malley. Secondly, you should get your facts straight because every time you speak in these hearings, you're full of crap. The more you run your mouth, the more you show the American people what a moron you are." He continues, "What have you done for working people in Oklahoma? Last time I checked, your state ranks near the bottom in median wages."
Damn.
"Sounds like you need to shut your mouth and get to work for the people of your state."
Say it, brother.
"They deserve action, not your phony man of the people spiel."
Preach it.
And that tweet really set Mullin off. Before we get to that,
yes. All right, so a couple of things. First, look, if you don't say, hey, I only made $50,000 when I first started my plumbing business, etc., no problem, and I believe that. If you want to pretend you're making $50,000 now when you're actually making $600,000, no. Okay. And hey, you want to make $600,000 and you've got a really successful business that's worth like $75 million, no problem, I get it. That's a normal salary in that range. But don't pretend you're making $50,000 a year when you might be worth $75 million.
Seriously.
Why don't you just say, I'm a fraud? Okay, so And again, nothing wrong with saying how you work your way up, but if you're pretending that you're, oh, I'm man of the people, my plumbing company, I only make 50,000, get out of here, right? So now, I love O'Brien's fighting attitude, because normally my whole life, here's how it's gone until about a year ago. Republicans will have these hearings, they'll call up these witnesses, whether they're Democrats, union, or expert scientists, etc.
They'll punch people in the mouth.
Yeah, they'll browbeat the hell out of them. They'll be like, oh, did you once say that you like cats more than dogs, you monster? And the person will be like, oh, I'm so sorry, right? And they'll never fight back. Why? Because Democratic politicians tell them ahead of time, make
that's,
sure
that's
you kneel.
Cenk, come on. This is, why do you do this? No one, you have no evidence of that. You don't need to take it an extra mile by just making things up. Come on, Cenk. You think Democrats sit down, they take the people that they have chosen to engage in these hearings, they sit them down and say, now we want you to be weak, and we want you to bow your head and embarrass us.
No, I'll tell you the exact words they use. They use, now remember, when you're in congressional hearing, this is very serious and somber, and you need to be civil. They don't tell them to be weak, they tell them be civil, and hey, don't push back, let us do it. I know that. I know that for a fact. So, okay, fine. They don't tell them to be super weak. They tell them to be super civil. Wink. Okay. Why do you think for 25 years straight I'm covering politics and nobody ever pushes back against Republicans in these hearings? And you know why they're doing it now? Because people realize, oh, when you push back, it goes viral and then you fundraise off of it. I'm keeping it real. Okay, so they stop listening to the Democratic consultants and politicians telling them to keep it civil. And now the people are getting famous by pushing back and they're going, oh, positive reinforcement.
Okay.
But anyway, I like this guy's fighting attitude.
So there was one other tweet from O'Brien that I think really did trigger Mullin. So he writes, greedy CEO who pretends like he's self-made, in reality, just a clown and fraud, always has been, always will be. Quit the tough guy act in these Senate hearings. You know where to find me, any place, anytime, cowboy. Okay, and he includes a photo of Markwayne Mullin standing on like a little platform in order to appear tall, you know, I think during a debate.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's the kind of thing Trump would do, and I like it. So I want people fighting back for us and for workers in this case. I don't want him to do it by lying, but the Michelle Obama commandment of when they go low, we go high is the world's worst political strategy. So O'Brien, keep going low. I love it, brother.
So Markwayne Mullin responded to that with a proposal. And here's what the proposal says. An attention-seeking union Teamster boss is trying to be punchy after our Senate hearing. Okay, I accept your challenge. MMA fight for charity of our choice, September 30th in Tulsa, Oklahoma. I'll give you 3 days to accept. So he is now like being very specific about like an MMA match with a Teamster, with a Teamsters general president. Now, the other thing is, according to Mullin's government biography, he does have quite a history with MMA, which I didn't know about. So apparently, Mullin is a former undefeated mixed martial arts fighter with a professional record of 5-0. He was inducted into the Oklahoma Wrestling Hall of Fame in 2016. Mullin has remained active in the wrestling community since his retirement from the sport, continuing to coach his children and other young athletes in wrestling tournaments across the country on weekends through today.
Yeah, if he's a championship wrestler, a real one, not a WWE, he's probably pretty good. Okay, so, okay, for whatever that's worth. And guys, as I said last week when we covered the potential Elon Musk Zuckerberg fight slash challenge. I'm sorry, I partly started all this stuff. And I did it with Smirkonish like 15 years ago. We didn't actually have the fight, but I asked for something along these lines. I did it with Rogan, etc. So I'm part of the circus, it's partly my fault. But now whenever there's a conflict, everybody's like, all right, let's go MMA. Let's go, let's get in the ring, etc. Now none of them have actually done it, but it's afoot. And so, is that the best way to actually settle scores? No, of course not. Guys, we've become idiocracy, right?
Absolutely.
And so that's why I say I'm partly guilty. I was making a rhetorical point that if they're gonna pretend to be tough guys, okay, I would rather debate you. I challenge them to a debate. If you don't want the debate, okay, we could do something along the lines of MMA, etc. Smirkonish ran, Rogan didn't answer, which partly goes to my point. I don't think they want to do it. In this case, Mullin says, all right, I'll be your Huckleberry. And now I gotta say, I hope they don't do it. They're grown ass men.
This is crazy. No.
One's a senator, the other one's a head of a union. What are you guys doing? No, yeah. Don't do that.
Yeah, I agree. And you know, I love O'Brien. I'm on his side, but he was the one who kind of hinted at anytime, anyplace, cowboy.
No, I know, right? But I'm not gonna blame him for that.
No, I mean, yeah.
Because Mullin, they didn't. There's no actual violence here, guys. That's the line. You cross that line, especially in a non, you know, athletic environment, right? You do not ever cross that line. But in this case, Mullen's constantly like picking at him and calling him corrupt. When I guarantee you, like, O'Brien, here, let me help you. Forget the fighting, okay? Find a list of all of his corporate donors.
Yes.
Okay, and day after day, here's this bribe, and here's this bribe, and here's this bribe. Because I guarantee you, Mullin has taken hundreds of bribes from corporations in the form of campaign contributions, okay? Call him what a filthy scum he is, who sold out his voters. And you're right, that's why they have lower wages, because Mullin gets bribed to make sure they have lower wages.
I mean,
hit him where it actually hurts.
Even better, I would look into his personal stock investments, and I would do a little bit of an investigation into that, right? No, but seriously, like, is Markwayne Mullin gonna look out for American workers when he is invested in the companies they work for and has a vested interest in maximizing the profits for these companies so he gets a better return on his investment?
I mean, that could be a thing, and it could be, and I wanna see, make sure
that's
he didn't.
That's a huge thing.
I wanna make sure he didn't do insider trading like a lot of people in Congress are doing, get information and then profit off of it. So there's a lot to investigate with Mark Wingro over here. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.